E3 2021 comes to a close, we want to take the time to honor the developers' hard work and the oohs and ahs they gave us over the last 4 days. Voted on by representatives from our media partners, IGN, IGN China, PC Gamer, GameSpot, GamesRadar, and Game Bonfire, we have selected the most anticipated games that were announced by each developer or publisher, as well as the most anticipated game overall announced all week long. To be eligible for an individual award, developer, publisher, or studio had to showcase more than one game, and we will even honor the best presentation of this year's Expo. So with that, drumroll please, Golden Boy. We present to you the 2021 E3 Awards. All right, starting with our first developer, Ubisoft. The award for most anticipated Ubisoft game goes to Mario and Rabbids Sparks of Hope.
Okay. I didn't see it coming.
And I was going to say Far Cry. I thought that would have been a shoe-in,
yeah,
right?
Too.
I didn't see that one coming. But
well, when this one was, kind of got out there a little early, everyone was excited
sure,
about
no,
it.
Sure, no, no. I love Mario Rabbids, so yeah. Another yeah. one I'm all about. Yeah.
First game was fantastic. No shocker here. This is cool.
Yeah, makes sense, I guess, on that one. Mm-hmm. So let's move on then. Gearbox Software closed us out on Saturday's preview night, and the award for most anticipated game from their presentation goes to Tiny
Yay!
Tina's Wonderland. Of course. No offense to Godfall, but of course it was
yeah,
going to be Tiny Tina's.
Exactly.
Like, that was the one, right, that we've been aching for more information on, right?
Totally.
Still just getting that sizzle teaser. It's like, okay, let's a little bit. I know,
just
right?
Just a little yeah. taste, but definitely in for that one. I mean, the cast alone, Will
sure.
Arnett, Wanda
yeah.
Sykes, Adam Sandberg, I'm like,
Ashley Burch.
Andy, I just.
Put some respect on the name, all right?
I was
yeah,
thinking,
Ashley Burch.
I don't know why I just said Adam.
I think you're thinking Sandler.
I didn't think
you. Andy Samberg will be really mad about that. So
sorry,
somebody
put
this out, send it to Andy Samberg. So
send it to Andy's people.
Next up for discussion is Xbox and Bethesda, and the award for most anticipated game for Xbox or Bethesda is Golden Boy.
Halo Infinite. Yes.
No Redfall. Thing.
Can you really? I mean, don't get me wrong.
No,
Redfall
Halo
looks awesome.
Infinite,
go get him, Arcane.
Yes,
but like,
for sure, for sure.
Yeah, I'm excited for this one. Well, obviously for it being Halo, but for the future of the franchise, it looks really good. They did a great Passover with the graphics, which is something everyone really wanted
yeah.
to see. They also had an awesome multiplayer showcase where they showed a whole bunch of new features like bots that are going to be coming to the game, which is great for players that maybe are a little too intimidated to play against actual players. That they could, you know, go in there, learn the ropes,
yep.
get in, play some Halo against their friends. It's awesome. I'm so excited for Halo Infinite.
All right. Square Enix caught our attention with their list of announcements, but the award for most anticipated Square Enix game goes to Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yay, you're all smiles.
I am all smiles.
Yeah.
A shoe-in again. I Lost Montreal coming out. This is what we've been talking about all week long when we were previewing and hinting around about rumors, right? Of
yeah.
like, I Lost Montreal, incredibly talented studio. Deus Ex, a game franchise, and especially their two, that
yeah.
has cemented them to so many fans as an amazing developer.
Yeah.
But it's a different kind of game. It's an IP maybe you don't connect with, maybe you don't get involved. Putting Marvel in front of that, I think, is really going to boost their profile and show the world what
yeah.
they can do the same way Insomniac did with Spider-Man.
It was such a great
exactly.
presentation, too. I mean, we got such an inside look at the game
yeah.
and saw the mechanics and just how the characters look and the funny lines delivered, so I'm excited for that one.
Of course.
Yep.
The PC gaming show was a lot of fun and brought us so many looks at an array of cool games on the horizon. But the award for most anticipated game of their presentation goes to Songs of Conquest.
Okay, interesting one. Yeah, if I, oh yes, this one was actually really nice.
I mean, look at the art style
the
right
animation.
There, right?
Pixel art style. I mean, that goes to show you, too, how many games were shown
yes.
at the PC Gamer
Showcase.
More than
30, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. But this is Coffee Stain, I believe, a great group. This is going to be a game to look out for, undoubtedly. Looks fantastic. And, you know, if it's a Coffee Stain production, you know it's going to have great
value.
You know
it's going to be good. You know
so many games
yeah.
embracing the stylized pixel art, and I love it.
Yes.
I'm here for it.
Yes.
I'm here for the classic twist, baby.
So did the entire media panel. That's all they talked
about. I
know,
exactly.
Week, right? Future Games wasn't to be outdone with a list of titles to catch our eyes. And the award for most anticipated game goes to Immortality. Don't read ahead.
Sorry, I cheated. excited.
You got ooh before I say what it is.
This is a very ominous teaser here. If you guys 100%. Remember, poster's just going up in flames as you're about to see behind us. So, yeah. I mean, for me, the music got me, and it was just the mystery of this one. So I definitely want to see more.
Sure. Well, I mean, coming off the success of Telling Lies, right? A game that relies on video footage, right? Getting into it. Her story, the game before that, that really established this from Sam, right? Going in, what's the story? You being the detective figuring it all out, immediately shot to the top of my list as well.
Yeah.
Okay, I won't cheat anymore.
Thank you. Don't. And Dolan Boy, don't you either.
All right? I promise.
And Television knocked our socks off with a family-friendly console reveal, and the most anticipated game from that presentation is...
Asteroids. Simple, baby.
A classic. It's a classic, right?
Yeah. You can't be mad about that, dude.
Yeah. I put Earthworm Jim.
Yeah, but that was just like they're working on an Earthworm Jim. You know what I mean?
Yeah, exactly.
They're gonna show the game. Okay. This is all about how the controllers work and getting everybody together to play a simple version of something, and that's Asteroids.
Asteroids wins. Okay.
Okay, good. Got Jackie's seal of approval, everybody. We're all right.
That's a real award.
When it comes to indies, there are so many great indie titles to choose from, and they all show us that there's really no gap between small games and AAA games in 2021. The award for most anticipated indie game goes to... Falling Frontier.
Oh, yeah.
This one got you, too? This is on your radar?
Yeah, this one looked really good. I mean, well, for one, anything with a space, you know, angle to it is always going to be a winner for me. And I believe this is the one that was, like, more of that strategic type of atmosphere that it presented. So I actually really like this game. And again, you know, the Indie Game Showcase was very competitive as well.
Yeah.
Lots of great games shown. Congratulations to them.
And I think, you know, the indie scene bled so much beyond the showcase, right? Where there were so many different indie games peppered throughout presentations, different publishers,
correct.
Even GameSpot today, like they had so many great things. Competitive space for sure. Speaking of competitive, Greg Way, Freedom Games established themselves again as a dev that makes family-friendly games that are fun. And the most anticipated one from their announcement goes to Airborne Kingdom. This is the first one I will argue about.
Okay.
What? Who did? Who did the dog?
I was like,
come on! It's a great game. I'm not knocking
it. Awesome.
To the rescue!
Really
no love for To the
Freedom
or
Games.
Cat Cafe Manager.
Exactly.
They had so
many good games.
There was too many good games.
For me, and I think for all of us, and even for our media friends, I think Freedom Games was like a star of the show for us.
Yes.
So many great games from that group, and I'm so excited to see what they're going to be bringing in the future. Because now that they're on the map, I'm sure more people are going to be paying attention.
100%, yeah, and I think their presentation was so good at putting developers as people front and center.
Yeah.
This is who we are. We're a small team. This is what we're
doing.
Goes to
show how passionate we are that we were like, there are so many games, you know, so it was awesome.
Yeah, showing their story to create the story. I love this.
Exactly. Yeah. All right, Capcom is no stranger to anticipated games in their library, and after Monday's presentation, the panel voted the most anticipated game is The Great Ace Attorney. Two great Japanese Phoenix Wright games coming
here. I thought your
Monstie
was going to get this
one. You know,
I
thought the Monstie would too, but I
was ready to say Monstie stories too as well. This game looks great though. I can't take it away.
Of course it does. Are you kidding me? Yeah. Go, I mean, Phoenix Wright already has such a passionate audience to finally get these games over from Japan, to go back in time, see the lineage of it, be in merry old England. Oi, governor. I mean, come on.
Yeah. And Herlock Sholmes.
Yes, exactly.
Best name ever. So that's a winner.
Love it.
That's a winner.
Good job, Capcom. Now, Nintendo opened up the final day today, dropping a few gems, but the award for most anticipated announcement had to go to Breath of the Wild 2. Come on, Legend of Zelda, Breath of the Wild 2.
I'll argue this one, man. Metroid was great.
Oh, Metroid was really good.
I know people are going to fight me on that one. I'm just excited for Metroid. Sorry, don't mind me.
Are you excited for Breath of the Wild 2, though?
Yes, I am, obviously. Nintendo showed a lot of awesome stuff. Breath of the Wild 2, though, we were hoping we were going to get it. We got a lot more than what I was anticipating.
Me too.
And this is going to be a special one.
Yeah, of course, targeting 2022. I love how honest they're being of, like, we're targeting 2022. Like, there's a lot that goes into this game. A lot could happen. And we are, as we talked about multiple times throughout this entire show, coming off of a global pandemic.
Yes.
So it's a miracle we're getting any games, let alone the fact that we're seeing Nintendo be transparent about it, let alone the rest of their lineup, including Advance Wars, don't forget.
Oh, my goodness. Advance Wars. I just want to get my hand on that flamethrower gauntlet thingy and just...
Of course. Yeah, yeah.
Okay. You know, okay.
You don't have rage.
Me
issues.
And the violin.
A little concerned. This is my friend.
We got to see some great things from Eureka Studio. The award for most anticipated game from them is Loopmancer.
Yes. This one came out of the gate fast, and I think a lot of people were just like, visually stunning.
Yeah.
You know, side scroller, got a lot of action in there. I'm keeping this one on my radar for sure.
Okay. This trailer just hit all the check marks. Like you said, animation, the music, protagonist looks amazing. Look
production
at this
value.
Villain.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, 100%. So not surprised by that at all.
Yeah.
All right, guys. The appetizers are out of the way. It's time for the big ones. Ooh. We had a number of great presentations over the last 4 days, making this award a very difficult one to choose. But someone had to, and our panel voted. The best presentation of E3 this year was Xbox and Bethesda's showcase.
Without a doubt.
Yeah. Pedal to the metal from the start. It's all gas. It's Todd Howard. It's Starfield all the way through to Arcane and saying, hey, bite me. You know what I mean? And in between a million different games, what was it? It was more than 30 games with 27 of them coming to Game Pass. I might be getting
ridiculous,
the numbers wrong.
Ridiculous.
But yeah, the overwhelming majority being Game Pass day and day.
And I just wanted to point out that there was a lot of predictions going into this. I had thought that we were going to get Halo Infinite first, get that out of the way, and then we'll close out with Starfield. That's what I was hoping.
Yeah.
But the fact that Xbox was like, nope, Bethesda, you're going to open and close the show. You're going to give us all the good stuff. Like, I really feel good about this, you know, the future here for Bethesda as a huge Bethesda fan. And yeah, man, this was a great showing. Lots of great games.
I was gonna comment on the structure as well. I just thought when they started with Starfield, I was like, ooh, okay, bold choice, know? And then they had Halo Infinite in the middle, and it was just perfection, everything that I wanted. And then wrapping it up with vampires, I was just like, okay, they nailed it for me, so yeah.
And to put a bow on it, you know, leading into it, they talked about there will be a clear delineation between Xbox and Bethesda, which I for sure thought it was going to be, whatever, half Xbox, and then now let's turn it to our friends at Bethesda.
Could have been easily like
and instead, they delineated by saying, hey, I'm Todd Howard from Bethesda. Hey, I'm Pete Hines from Bethesda. Hey, I'm Phil from Xbox. And they shook it up that way so you knew what you were getting and how this whole ecosystem is going to work. That's impressive.
Yeah, I felt like the timing was perfect, and they delivered on every single title as much as I wanted. I didn't feel like, oh, I want more.
Yeah.
Whoa, okay, I'm getting a waterfall of info here, you know? So props to y'all.
Great stuff. But there can be only winner for the most anticipated game overall. A tough decision, I'm sure, amongst our media panel, but they decided to give the most anticipated game of 2021 to I was gonna see what they wanted. It's Forza Horizon. Forza Horizon 5 won most anticipated game overall.
Wow.
Shocking. Not because Forza's not a great game.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
But if you would have asked me, I'm going to say it's going to be Halo or it's going to be Breath of the Wild.
Too.
And you assume you get into one of the classic situations at an E3, right, where the votes got broken, where it was that a whole bunch of people went for Breath of the Wild and a whole bunch of people went the other direction for Halo or for whatever, and then here you go.
Well, Forza's also, remember, too, this is 2021, so perhaps, you know, the panel was also looking out what games
great
are going to be coming out
You're
this
right.
year. Forza,
right.
obviously, always a winner. Every Forza Horizon game has been brilliant. So this is not a shocker to me because these games are great. Visually speaking as well, ridiculous.
Gorgeous.
Like the whole time we're like, is that a picture? Or no, that's the game. And they knew it and they kept doing it and it worked every single time. Brilliant.
Yeah, I think I was telling Golden Boy earlier that I'm a very awful driver, and so I love games like this because then I can just like drive in these beautiful landscapes and incredibly expensive cars and, you know, not damage anything.
Yeah, of course, it doesn't cost you anything.
Yeah,
that's the best part.
I love these racing games.
Remind me never to get a car in Jackie.
I know,
exactly.
I know,
stay away from riding with Jackie.
That was a shocking winner, though.
It was, but one of the reasons I think it's shocking, but one of the reasons it's really cool is what you said, right? Is that year in, year out, Forza Horizon is great. It's amazing, right?
Yeah.
And so usually when you have something like that, what happens? Oh, you start to take it for granted. Oh, that's going to be awesome no matter
what.
I'm excited by the bells and whistles. I'm excited for the brand new thing. And then here you are. Everybody understands.
Well-deserved. Well-deserved.
Believe it or not, ladies and gentlemen, that's it for this year's coverage of E3, everyone. A huge thank you to our friends at Binge and iHeartRadio, the number one podcasting platform in the United States. Of course, thank you to our entire media crew, the team at IGN, and all the developers over the last 4 days. I will leave you with one final message. We will see you all back here in person, live from Los Angeles in 2022.
Woo!
Thank you, everybody.
Bye.
Bye, everybody.
Mm-hmm.